To remove the spring, you just have to remove this one 18 millimeter bolt. You have to counter hold it from the rear and then zip it off. Once it's loosened, you can pull it out. Now, if it's under tension, that means that it's being pressed on by the lower control arm. So you just have to put a jack on the lower control arm and move it around until it's under neutral tension from the rear spring. Once you remove the bolt, the control arm is only held at one end, so you can just press it down and the spring will come out. To remove the rear shock, just remove this bolt down here and these two bolts up here, and then the shock will just come right out. Before you install your new springs, note how the old springs sit in the bushings. So down there, there's a little bump where the end of the coil should sit. And if you look at the upper strut mount, you can actually see where the end of the coil was sitting. So make sure it's installed in the same orientation. Here's the bottom of the control arm. You can see a nub where the spring should rest. And if you look at the mount, you should be able to see the wear marks from where the spring was resting when it was in place. Here's the stock spring and my aftermarket spring. I got these Shine Racing springs from KermerTDI.com. As you can see, they are kitty approved. And you can also see that they're quite a bit thicker than the stock springs, but a little bit shorter. What this means is that it'll give a firmer ride while still maintaining stock ride height. Once the car's weight compresses the springs, this will compress less than this. If you want to maintain stock ride height while just increasing the spring rate, then this is your best bet. And as you can see, they are kitty approved. When installing the springs, make sure that you use a new lower control arm bolt. This is a single-use torque-to-yield bolt, and if it fails, you won't be happy. And put a jack on the lower control arm to raise the suspension arm to the neutral position. It has to be in the neutral position so that the suspension bushings aren't preloaded. Then torque this bolt to 66 foot-pounds plus a quarter turn. So after we get confirmation that it's torqued correctly, then you have to torque this to another quarter turn. You can use a piece of chalk or a marker just to mark the bolt head. Now, when you torque something down, you are supposed to tighten the end that moves, not this end, but I just don't have access to this other end, so that's why I'm tightening this end. Again, the suspension must be in the resting position so that the bushings aren't preloaded. Let the suspension settle in for a day or so, drive it around, then get an alignment because your alignment will have changed. Check out my other video for the front suspension install. Check out my YouTube channel for lots more useful videos and my website, myturbodiesel.com, for more useful diesel tips and videos. Thanks for watching. Good luck.